Welcome once again to keep on learning online class. My name is Teacher Emmanuel, a teacher of geography. Today we are going to learn geography where we are still on the physical geography. Today we are going to discuss about revision questions. So our topic of today are basically going to focus on the hydrological cycle. And this hydrological cycle of water, it is studied from primary up to secondary level. Let's start by this question. We have question one, which has part A and B. A, define the term hydrological cycle. So we gave different definition of hydrological cycle, where this definition one starts saying is the continuous movement of water on, above, and below the surface of the earth. We have also another definition, is the endless interchange of water between the sea, the atmosphere, and the land. Not only the sea, but also any other kind of water body, whether it is a lake, whether it is an ocean, or any other kind of water body. So when you talk of hydrological cycle, as we mentioned above, about the two definitions, hydrological cycle is a continuous movement of water on, above, below the surface of the earth. It means this cycle, it combines three parts. We have the part of water, the part of atmosphere, and the part of the surface of the earth. Meaning that when you talk of this hydrological cycle of water, I think it is very easy to understand. But you are going to understand when you will be discussing about different processes relating to this hydrological cycle. Let's go to question part B. Question one, part B. Describe the processes involved in the hydrological cycle. So those are processes. We are going to see how this hydrological cycle of water occurs. Let's start by evaporation. When you talk of evaporation, this is the changing of water into a water vapor after being heated by solar radiation. Meaning that the water, after getting heat, after becoming heated, it will start becoming as if it is a gas. That's what you call evaporation. This is process number one. Process number two, we have cooling. When you talk of a cooling, this is a reduction of water vapor temperature as it rises into the atmosphere. Meaning that as the water vapor rises to the atmosphere, just under like, you know, the temperature decreases with an increase in altitude. Meaning that whenever this air moves up, this water vapor moves up, it is approaching the lowest temperature. And as a result of that, it will start cooling, and such a process is referred to as a cooling. Let's go to the next process of condensation. When you talk about condensation, this is the turning of water vapor into a thin water droplets, which form clouds when cooling continues below a dew point. Meaning that when you talk about condensation, this is where, when the water vapor cools, it will condense. Or when it becomes cools, it will condense. And when it is condensed, it leads to the formation of clouds. And those clouds, when they become too heavy, they will fall as rainfall, or as a hail, as a snow, as a fog, as a dew. And the falling of rain, hail, storm, snow, fog, and any other kind of, is on the earth surface, is referred to as precipitation. And you have another stage or another process of hydrological cycle of water. We have what you call surface runoff. After rain, when it rains, some of the amount of rain waters or some of amount of droplets of rain will sink, will penetrate into the ground, while others will flow on the surface of the earth. And we have also infiltration. When you talk of infiltration, this is entry of water into the ground through pores. It means the rainwater which falls on the surface of the earth, some of the amount will penetrate through the pores or joints or cracks in the rocks. And finally, we have what we call percolation. When you talk of percolation, this is downwards and sideways movement of water that has entered into the ground. So, to have further understanding, let's look at the diagram showing this hydrological cycle. As we said, the first process is evaporation. When sun rises into the water will get heated. After getting heated, it will start evaporate. So this is what we call evaporation. After this evaporation, the air will move upwards or will move to the atmosphere. As it moves upwards, as temperature decreases and it starts cooling. When the air cools, it is the second stage of this hydrological cycle. It will condense, which is condensation, to form clouds. And remember, when those clouds become too heavy, they will fall as rain, they will fall as hail, they will fall as fog. And such a process is precipitation. And the rainwater which fall on the surface of the earth, some of them will infiltrate, others will flow to the surface. And such a process of flowing to the surface is surface runoff. And the water which has entered through pores or cracks is referred to as infiltration. I think this process of hydrological cycle of water is very easy to understand. Have nice time. Don't forget to subscribe and write and give comment so that you can improve our teaching and learning practice.